I'm excited to be a part of the conference, and certainly being someone that's been in college athletics for a while now, I have tremendous respect for what this conference has achieved in a short time, and I'm honored to be a part of such a well-respected national image that the American has. So excited to be at East Carolina, but excited to be in the American Conference.
We hear the Commissioner Mike Rasko talk a lot about the Power Six and just the importance of that to him in establishing that, you know, this conference is right up there with the Big Ten, the Big 12, the Pac-12, the ACC, and the SEC. What do you feel about, you know, that P6 conversation? Do you address it at all?
Well, I mean, I think certainly it's obvious that this conference is more like the other Power Five schools than we are like the other Group of Five conferences, just from play on the field.
Yeah.
And I think that the track record of the teams in this conference against other Power Five schools over the past 7 years has given that credibility. So I think there's, you know, there's obviously some you know, space to say that and the Power Six label. Do I think that we will ever join the other Power Fives and become an autonomous conference? I don't know. I would think they're pretty protective.
Yeah.
So, but I think we're certainly in the conversation.
There's the Power Five was a media created term. The autonomous five that you brought up was legislative. So if we stop saying Power Five, it doesn't exist. I mean, just what you think about that aspect.
Right. And that's, you know, that's why we, you know, the whole Power Six label, you know, it's kind of the same thing. If you say it, then it exists. But at the end of the day, it's to me, it's all about how recruits view you. And if recruits view us more in the Power Five model than the Group of Five, then to me, that's a win for us, because you know, the high school recruits want to play at the highest level. They want to play on TV. They want to have a chance to play in the NFL. And I think the product that we put on the field week in and week out in this league is one that gives them the opportunity to do all those things.
When East Carolina came into the American, they had Ruffin McNeil and
yep.
went on to Scotty Montgomery. For you, what can you say about the choice of going to East Carolina? You and I spoke about it in the spring teleconference a little bit, but
right.
just what your overall feel is about why East Carolina, why right now?
Well, I think number one is I've always known East Carolina growing up in the state of North Carolina. And I know Ruffin and knew a lot of the coaches on his staff. Some of them are on my staff now. So I was fairly close to that program through them when he was here. And, you know, when you know, my wife and I, we started talking about, you know, what might be our next step for our family and my career. East Carolina has always been in that conversation, just because regionally this is where we want to be in the country, you know, to raise our two boys. So when the opportunity became available, number one, it's one I was really excited about. Number two, I do think the timing is really good. I think that it's, you know, it's certainly been down for a couple of years, the last three, but I think it's a place that has tremendous upside, tremendous potential, and I think really it's just a gold mine. And, you know, I think anytime you can take a job like that where you see a bright future and you see hope, you know, that's all you can ask for. You know, just give me a chance. And so we're excited about the opportunity there and excited about what lies ahead of us.
You went exactly where I was going to go, which is the potential. Why is there potential at East Carolina? What do you see there, be it facilities, be it location, be it, you know, whatever your vision has of the coaches that you brought in and maybe how they attack it? What is the potential of East Carolina?
Well, I think number one, there's been, has been, and is continuing to be a strong commitment from the institution to upgrade our facilities. And I think that with the expansion of Dowdy Ficklin Stadium and the new Southside Tower, we're going to have one of the top venues in the American Conference this fall. And so I think that's one thing where, you know, if you can get recruits on the campus where they see the commitment, and I think that makes a strong impression. I think the second is our fan base. You know, our fan base is passionate about Pirate football. And so you get in that stadium on game day and it's 50,000, you know, screaming Pirates, and you feel that energy. You can't replicate that. You can't fake that. And there are very few schools that have that. And so all those things mean that you're going to be able to recruit, you know, some of the top players regionally. And if you can get that, then you got a shot. So I think that I think there's no reason why that I shouldn't expect in the next 3 years or so Florida to have a program that's competing at the top of the American Conference.
When you see a packed state like North Carolina with North Carolina, NC State, yourselves, yep. Duke, so on and so forth, just how you feel about, you know, tackling that and seeing that piece of it, that there is a lot of talent in North Carolina. Yep. There's a lot of teams going after that talent.
Right, and there's a lot of people coming into North Carolina.
Yeah.
So, you know, certainly we want to attack and try to recruit the top players in the state of North Carolina. You know, they're going to all have an opportunity to play at East Carolina, but there are a lot of us in the state and regionally that are going to get an opportunity also. So I think we've got to be a regional school. We've kind of established our footprint as being, you know, kind of New Jersey to Orlando, East Coast. You know, we're going to dip into some spots in Texas and some other places, but we really want to stay regional and really want to stay primarily within a five-hour footprint. I think there's really strong football when you talk about, you know, Virginia, the Carolinas, Maryland, Georgia, that's very, very close to proximity with Greenville, North Carolina, where we can really build a strong foundation.